Hey everyone, this is Father Christian for the Tease for this week for the first Sunday in Lent. As you know, Father Joe and I have been doing these little teases that come out on the Friday Eve blast to let you know what's happening this weekend, give you an idea of what the gospel or what the sermon might be all about. What I want to look at is the psalm, believe it or not, for this Sunday, and it's Psalm 25, verses 1 through 9. And of course, we use the translation from the Book of Common Prayer. So in Psalm 25, verses 1 through 9, there is verse 6. And verse 6 says, "Remember not the sins of my youth and my transgressions. Remember me according to your love and for the sake of your goodness, O Lord." And then today is Thursday that I'm recording this. The epistle today for the daily lectionary was from Philippians, where Paul says, we're not looking to the past. We're straining forward to the future, where we are citizens of heaven. And so there's this theme that we see of the past is the past and the past is gone, but we strain and we lean forward to the future. And often what holds us in our past can be our sins, can be our past transgressions, can be choices that we made in the past, bad choices that we've made. However, we can't let them define us for who we are in the present and where we go in the future. They have sculpted who we are and they inform us and they help us to make better decisions and choices. And we also ask God to redeem those bad choices that we made, to say, God, what do you want to do with this? Because all I'm doing is just living in the darkness of it. And I know that you make beauty out of everything. So help me, God, to see your hand at work in everything. Remember not the sins of my youth and my transgressions. Remember me according to your love. This Sunday will also be the gospel of Jesus' baptism that is shown to us in the Gospel of Mark. And when Jesus rises out of the water, remember what God the Father says. We have the whole Holy Trinity present in this text. When he comes up out of the water, a voice came and said, "You are my son, the beloved. With you I am well pleased." And so for us, when we get to Easter and we celebrate many baptisms here at St. Mary's, we're saying the same thing to those men, women, boys, and girls, and saying, "You are my son, you are my daughter, you are beloved, and in you I am well pleased." It doesn't say, "I am well pleased except when you sin." It doesn't say that. You've been forgiven because, however, you're going to repent, leave that in the past so you can lean into a new version, a new creation, a rebirth of who you are. So my question to you before this Sunday is, have you accepted that? Have you accepted that you can leave the past and move forward to where there's fruit bearing for you and allow your sins and transgressions of the past just to become ways to opportunities for redemption, opportunities for lessons, and opportunities for things to make you stronger as opposed to living and being tethered in the past and of sin and of guilt and of dysfunction? That's not the life. God wants life for you, for me, for all of us. That's where we can really channel his beauty into this world. Okay, friends, just a reminder, too, that we will begin this next coming Wednesday of the Lenten series. And we'll be talking about how do we dig even deeper with all of this work of these disciplines. How do we stay in the present moment? How does our prayer life, our scripture life, our confession life, our service work, how does that all keep us here in the present with God now to bear the fruit that God has us for now as we strain and lean forward into the future of what God is doing and in revealing the kingdom of God? Okay, my friends, we'll see you this weekend for the first Sunday in Lent, and then also hopefully next Wednesday for the Lenten series, 6 p.m. in Ross Hall for a simple soup supper from 6 to 6:30, and then we will teach from 6:30 to 8, and it'll be much more of a collective engagement from table to table so we can really all have a voice in this great work that we're doing and getting going deeper and deeper with God. All right, my friends, God bless you. Peace. Bye-bye.